guys, it's me. I'm back. It's your girl. Just kidding. I hate people that do that. And myself, so yay. So today I'm super hyped because I'm gonna be reacting to Post Malone's latest album, Austin. First of all, let me just say I love that title. Like, I love that he just named it Austin. It's just simple and beautiful and amazing, just like him. For anybody that doesn't know, I am a huge Post Malone fan. He is probably my favorite. If you hear something that sounds like a demon in the background, it's my cat. He's like on crack right now. Post Malone is my favorite artist. Maybe not of all time, because I like a lot of artists and genres and time periods and stuff, but he's my favorite current artist, and he has been since he came out. I'm so hyped because I heard that this album is supposed to be like more mellow, like more acoustic vibes. I'm super excited because I love that he is so versatile and he can do any genre. I really love when he does hip hop. I like when he raps and stuff, but you know, it's been a minute. I love when he does rock. I love when he does country, and I don't even like country. Unless it's like the really old classics, which is really what he covers, so probably why I like it. But anyway, on Stony, Feeling Whitney is my jam. It's my jam, okay? And pretty much since then, really pretty much since he did like the YouTube Bob Dylan's Don't Think Twice, okay? I have wanted this album. So I hope that the hype is real, that it's really this kind of album, because I've not heard it, and I don't want to be disappointed, but I'm super excited. I hope that that's what this is going to be. Even though he never really disappoints, I mean, I love all of his albums. Probably Hollywood Bleeding is my least favorite. It was just a little too poppy for me. I feel like pop is my least favorite genre, and there was a lot of pop in that album, in my opinion. I really love Hollywood's Bleeding. It's a great song. I don't know, maybe like Stony. Don't worry about it. Stony and Beer Bongs and Bentleys maybe are my top two. But I just love like his mellow stuff. Like even like Lemon Tree. Lemon Tree was my favorite out of the last album. Well, I don't know, it's hard. I really like, okay, I could be here all day. We're not gonna do this. I'm gonna be reacting to each individual song. So it's not gonna be like an hour long reaction, unless I keep talking. it'll just be for each song. And I will probably have this intro on all of the videos that I release for this album. So if you have already seen one of my reactions to the songs, the next one, you can just skip the intro. Let's be real, you can always skip the intro, and I'm sure you do, so ignore me. I feel like there was something else I was gonna say. There are a few songs that I'm not gonna be reacting to from this album because I've already heard them, and I'm not fake, so I'm not gonna pretend like I haven't heard them. I've already heard them. So I've already heard Overdrive, I've already heard Chemical, and I've already heard Morning, which, by the way, Morning's video, what what was it? What does it mean? I was talking to Nick about it, like trying to think of, like, you know, what it could possibly represent, and he's like, it's not that deep. It's post, like, he's It's nothing. I'm super excited. You guys ready? Let's get into it. This one is gonna be Hold My Breath. Talk too much. Drink too much. Please don't leave, 'cause you're holding on to something special to me. It's essential to me. I might be in love with this song.
Please don't leave, 'cause you're holding on to something special to me.
I love it.
It's essential to me. Say that you love me. Don't waste my time.
Preach. Wow. I really love that one. Like, definitely going on the playlist. Wow. That was so great. It was beautiful, and I love his voice. Great lyrics, very relatable. And definitely the kind of song that I expected on this album from what I heard. Like, I'm pretty hyped. Hope there's more like that. All right. Bye, guys.